see not that one there?
Hello, it's me.
Again.
Clive from Houston.
We've got Neves, Ruben Neves, and I don't know any more words.
Probably just as well, I think. Introduce yourself again.
This what? Is Rick Rack.
It is, and I'll come here. I've got to give you a clip round the ear out of the corner to step. Is that right? That's what you want.
A kiss
with you. Yeah.
There you go, mate.
Yes, it is as well. We know it's something about him. You're not like you, and didn't share with anybody there. First thing in the morning. You want to read his poem? You said,
mate. It was Bill, was it? Me? That's for a tin of cup of tea.
That's still coming. The mixed grill and
the old lady. Did you get a close-up?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
What we ought to do is take a mix of albums.
You're going to find one of the biggest tears on this channel.
I don't
think
so. No,
it's not.
You take
Clive.
You
take Clive.
You're always in the front.
It wasn't last week. It was a lot of
people. Been at my scorpion, blazing on a sunny afternoon. And I can sell my
he just sung that line.
Everything I've got, all I got's a sunny afternoon. Help me sail away. I give me two good reasons why I ought to stay. Cause I love to live so pleasantly. Live my life for luxury. Blazing on a sunny afternoon. In a summertime. In a summertime.
That's it.
Beautiful.
I know you are smart.
Yeah, I'm smart.
Oh,
thank you so much. Thank you. I will enjoy it. My pleasure. Thank you.
Hello to the Wolves. Hi there.
Houston Wolves.
Hi.
Thank you.
Very well done, mate. Say something intelligent.
No chance.
Go away, West Bromwich Albion.
Yeah. In short, sharp, jerky movements.
Yes.
20, 30, 40, 50 or more. The Coventry supporters lying dead on the floor. 80 coppers died trying to end that spree. The day the North Bank took Coventry.
This is the famous cheeseburger.
Even I enjoy your posts.
Oh dear.
You must be as bad as everybody else.
Emails are not allowed to read the blog.
Oh, yeah. He reads them to me.
Oh, okay.
At bedtime.
Oh, you can't read. Oh, bedtime stories. Yeah. You're a bloody sad bugger.
Say cheese, everybody. That's got to be worth a picture at least.
Close his ears.
She's coming next year, by the way.
Okay, there's a couple of people here who would like to say something. Are you ready? Are you there?
Wrong number.
Talking close.
She's got that.
You're welcome. All right, I'll see. Talk to you later.
Bye,
love.
Wolves blogger. I don't have a t-shirt to expose, but you can see my gay moose. And that's it. I've been told to keep it short, so the end.
Everywhere we go, people want to know,
people want to know,
where the hell are you from,
where the hell are you from,
we're from Wolverhampton,
we're from Wolverhampton,
lovely Wolverhampton,
sunny Wolverhampton.
Just a perfect day, you made me forget myself. I thought I was someone else, someone good. Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep me hanging on.
May, the day after last match of the season. As you all probably know, this is Clive from Houston, who travelled a million miles to watch us fail miserably to get in the playoffs. I just love to say that it's been fantastic meeting a lot more fellow bloggers. Even Peak Wolf bought me a drink, which was incredible, and Brompton didn't insult me too much, and we had a fabulous dinner at the Parkview Hotel on Friday evening, where we got hammered, scooped, forgot where he was, what religion he is, even what sex he is. And then Saturday was, it was magical for me because I only see the Wolves once a year, which some would say is a blessing. But the whole atmosphere was great. And then before and after the game down here at the Parkview Hotel, we had wonderful times. We shared wonderful memories, and we were hosted magnificently by Mr. and Mrs. Do-Gooder. So I would like to say thank you to Ben and Thomas initially for starting the blog many years ago, and then for all their sterling work in keeping the blog going through lots of difficult personal circumstances for them. A belated congratulations to Thomas for unexpectedly becoming a father. We didn't expect him to. And thanks to all of fellow bloggers for their fabulous contributions, both agreeing and disagreeing with each other. And what I really appreciate about the blog is there are no criticisms of grammar and spelling, etc. There's no backbiting to each other. We just respect that we've all got differing opinions. So that's it really. I would say again, thanks everybody, and my usual signing off, a very happy fuck up West Brom to all of you.
I might say a short word.